can be difficult to stop a big rig that's speeding out of control.
Denver 7's Jace Larson jumped in a semi today. He rode down from the mountains along that stretch of road just before the accident happened. Jace is live in our newsroom. So what was that like, Jace?
You know, guys, big rigs are very different in terms of shifting compared to a passenger car that's a stick shift. In a stick shift passenger car, you can force it into a lower gear. But when you're going too fast, it's not possible for semi drivers in many situations. To see just what it takes to keep one of these under control,
I've been driving for 35 years.
We jumped in the cab with United States Driving School instructor Tyree Armstrong. We drove I-70 coming down from the mountains where the brakes of so many truckers get hot.
If the brakes are hot, and I mean extremely hot, they will not react and hold back the cargo or the trailer and the tractor if it's extremely hot. It'll just kind of just be there, like feel like a sponge.
It's a misconception, he says, that a trucker can just downshift. Once you take the semi out of gear, you often can't get it into a lower one.
You cannot downshift it. I'm going to show you.
Going faster than a lower gear would allow, with our trailer empty for safety, he showed us what a driver might face.
It goes like that.
The stick shift just won't go into gear.
That's what happens. You can upshift all day. You can't downshift.
In most cases, you have to match the RPMs with the transmission.
Richard Lammers owns the trucking school. The transmission will simply not accept a downshift when the gears are moving too fast.
There is no solution.
Tyree says most truckers in an emergency are trained to do whatever they can to avoid hitting and injuring someone else.
If they can get it off the road in a safe way, I would tell them put it in the ditch.
And just to be clear, investigators have not released exactly what caused the truck yesterday to go out of control. Ann?
All right. Thank you so much, Jason.